Hey, good morning, everybody. So today I want to make a video. I've had a lot of questions recently in regards to this tent, and we haven't used it in a bit, so I wanted to bring it out and show you guys the tent all set up and what it looks like. I'm gonna go with a little bit of the details of how it works, what are the things you need to do with it, what are my tricks, and how I get things done with it. So this in the background is what we call the Dometic Hayling 6. It is a tent that is with air compression to get the tubes to fill up. So you guys will see in the video, but all these tubes here, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, you have 5 tubes, and these are all filled with air. So you don't need the traditional stick and pull type of situation. You just fill them with air and the whole tent will then pop up on its own. It is a very, very durable tent. We've had it now for, I don't know, maybe I think 2 years or so, maybe going on 3 years, and it's worked out very good for us. We've done multiple trips with it. We like to bring it out more when it starts getting a little cooler here in South Florida, because in the summertime, as anyone knows, camping with a tent gets very hot regardless if you have an air conditioner or not in it. But as you can see, we have it all opened up right now. This is with the windows, because it has, I'll show you now, but it has little drapes to close and open the windows so you can let light in. And then also we have the bug net open versus just having the whole door closed completely. But let's go around first on the outside, show you a little bit on the outside, show you how this works, and then we'll walk onto the inside and show you that part of it. But the tent here, we didn't put these up, but these are guidelines I use for when it's, you know, stronger winds. We don't feel that you need them right now, so we just have them, you know, loose. But in the commercial where I originally saw this, they did put a helicopter and an airplane in front of it, and it was ripping and this thing went nowhere. So it's very, very good. We've actually been through maybe 2 storms at this point with this one. Pretty heavy winds and nothing has happened to it. So it's very good, even though we didn't use it. As you can see here, these are the poles I'm talking about. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 poles over here. These poles are with the air compression. I use the machine to fill them up. They give you a pump, which you manually do it with. A little bit too much work for me, so I bought a pump and I program it with 7 PSI. And then that will fill the airs for the tubes for me. This is where you fill them through. You have these little inlets where you take this part off to fill. You take it all off and it'll just let all the air out so you can close it up. It's very easy. So over here, this is the door. This is a second door you can have if you want. This is where I used to take out the pipe for the AC. So the AC pipe will come out through here. I don't never use this as a door. I just use it for this specific purpose, but you can have it as a door as also if you want to come in through the side, or just open it up and have it as another mosquito net so you can let some more air ventilation through. This tent, if I'm not mistaken, and I think someone did tell me in one of the comments recently, that they also sell the version where this is just the mosquito netting. I specifically wanted to get this plastic windows because we use it in South Florida heat, and that will help me keep in the air conditioning and stays a lot cooler in there. So as you can see, you have all these windows over here, and if you come around the back, it's a very big tent. If I'm not mistaken, the dimensions, I think it's 20 feet long by 12 feet wide. And it's very tall in there, and you'll see now when we get on into the inside. Come around to the back side over here. So over here on the back side, like I said, you have more of these guides, right? So you can really prop this thing up and make it super sturdy. It's not necessary for us right now in this weather condition, so we just did the traditional, just, you know, pegging it down on the corners and all that. It does come with this this floor mat, so you can put the tent on top of that. It just helps, you know, keep it all a little bit cleaner and out of the water. All right, so let's come around this side. Oh, actually, before we go back on top up here, is another pass through for the air, for the ventilation. So the air, when you have this propped up correctly, it would actually ventilate through the back, and it has another one in the front. Just helps out a little bit more with the air circulation inside the tent if you weren't using an air conditioner like we do. So we come around this way. Here on these backside panels, you also have this little thing here. These little sticks, you pop them up onto here on each corner. And it just helps keep this little back part here, which is where the room is, for the air circulation to go through, and keeps it a little bit less muggy in there. So you come on this way. On this side, you have a lot more of these open windows. Like I show you, I'll show you now for the, we have the curtains you can close and open. And here on these corners, you have one on this side, one on the other side. There are little pass-throughs that you can use to run electrical cords through. Specifically for that, you run electricity through there, so you don't have to have, you know, this whole rig going through there. Someone recently asked me on one of the videos if you can completely enclose this part here, and yes, you can. So I'll show you right here. If you can see that, there's a zipper, right? And this zipper goes all the way through, and they sell something called the vestibule. I think it's vestibule. You can have a couple different versions of it. You can either have it like that mosquito netting, or you can have it with the same plastic material and have it completely enclosed. So you have like a whole porch. You can have an additional area to sit down or see out of elements, or just keep different things out here to protect more protected. Here we like to use these Phoenix lights. At nighttime, it's kind of like a porch light. It helps out a whole lot to keep this area illuminated when it's really dark. Now, they also sell you this part here, which is kind of like the entrance. They have this little rug thing to keep it a little cleaner too. If it's a muddy, dirty, sandy area, it keeps it a little more nice and tight in here. We brought very minimal things this trip because we're only here for 2 days. But usually we come out, as you guys have seen in some of my other videos, we have a cooler, chairs, a garbage can. We have all that set up out here as well, but we didn't need any of those things now. Sorry, I got interrupted for a second there. But so as you can see, we have the mosquito net. This is the no-see-um, right? This is the netting for that. We have this door set up, but you can completely enclose it if you want to. You just gotta take this off here, which is basically what we do at nighttime. And then you can just close it up completely. And the zipper's here. And now you have a fully enclosed door. Nothing's getting through there, right? And let's go ahead. We like to leave like this. All right, so the reason I'm leaving it open right now, usually we have it closed and just leave the AC running, but I had a little bit of an issue yesterday. Our drain pipe broke, where the water, excess water comes out of the AC, and it kind of little puddles on the AC side there. So we're letting it dry out. No big deal. We'll get back to the house and we'll fix that. But let's go on inside. So one of the things you can see is both on the permanent, on the closed door and on the mosquito netting, if you have questions about bugs getting in or snakes or whatever it may be, as you can see on this section here, this floor is lifted, so it helps out the mud and all that stuff from getting in. But here as well has Velcro on both sides, so so the door velcros to that, either one of them, you know, and it's just comes a solid little enclosure where nothing can get in or out. And you can also just completely open it up if you want to, if you want to have no door. And then you can nail this. They have a version, a way you can stick this to the ground. It's just a straight surface that you can walk right in and out of. All right, so this is the inside. We bought the carpet that comes with it too. So you have a carpet on the inside. It makes it feel a lot nicer in here, especially if you're on top of rocks or anything of that nature. Over here, these are the windows I was talking about earlier. As you can see, these little curtains are on zippers. So you can let it go. You just open it up. And you zip it up. So if you zip it up, then it's basically number one for the sun, number two for privacy. No one can see in and out. During the daytime and usually until we go to sleep, we just like to leave them open completely. It's easy to grab them. Roll them up, and there you go. It's open up. So as you can see, I'm not a very tall person, but you have a good amount of space out here. So it makes it feel very big and open in here. We use this section. Like I said, we didn't bring many things and it's kind of scattered everywhere right now. We usually have very organized with a table and all that stuff on this side. Here is the AC that we have. I have this cord. Like I said, usually none of this is like this, but as you can see, unfortunately, it did get wet here. We have a bit of a puddle from the drain of the water because a lot of humidity here. But the AC is pretty much, we run it all night. We leave it around 64 and this thing gets super cold in here. So you're sleeping like if you're sleeping at home, right? Over here, as you can see, if you're sleeping with no AC, then what you would do is you just leave this door, the mosquito netting or the no-see-um, you leave that closed. And then you have a ventilation from here, ventilation in the back, and then you also have it on the side doors there. This is the door I was talking about. So this is where I take out the pipe that leads to the outside. The excess heat from the AC will go straight out through that pipe on the bottom. And then you can open this door as well. If you want to have it just as a mosquito no-see-um, or you want to have it closed, whatever you want to do, you have a couple options on this side here. Every single one of these things here, as you can see, this side, these two sides, and that side over there, these are all curtains you can open up and close. This one I have it halfway because we have our Dometic fridge here running. This Dometic fridge is where we keep all our drinks and food and all that stuff. Make sure that it stays cool. Great fridge, by the way. If you guys haven't seen my review on it, it's a CFX 35. Highly recommend it. It keeps everything as cool as you need to for as long as you need to, and it has a lot of capacity in there. This is the bedroom side. So you have either two bedrooms that you can just separate, or you can have one big bedroom, and I'll show you separation now. But it's a blackout. So what I like about it, as you guys can see right now, we're not in full sun because it's a pretty shaded area, but this part here, a lot of light comes through. So if you're trying to sleep through this, I mean, it's going to be pretty bright. So the cool thing is that this room, it's like a separated section within the tent that has this blackout material, and it makes it very dark. You can completely close these doors. One of the two options, you can completely close it up where you have no light or no air, nothing coming through. Or you can just leave it with the no-see-um as half the section. I'll close that up and show it to you now. And then over here in the center, you have like kind of like a little closet organizer space. We just kind of throw a little random stuff in here, or towels and things of that nature. Over here is where we sleep. We have this as our section. This is almost, I would think, like a full size. This is our 3-inch memory foam self-inflating mattress. Great mattress. We've had it for probably 3 years now. Great, great mattress. And then on this side is where the kids sleep. They each got their own twin inflatable bed. Sleep side by side here. As you guys can see here inside, it's gonna be pretty dark, but come on this way. Right here in the center, I don't know if it's dark, too dark or not, but here in the center, you have this little zipper where you can open it and you can have this as one full section, or you can separate it and have two separate bedrooms in here. You guys can sleep. As you guys can see, it's obviously way darker in here than it is over here. And you can really tell a difference, and it's, you know, obviously the same daylight, right? Now, let me show you the doors when they close up. For those of you that have maybe live in colder climates and stuff like that, maybe a very good option for you. We don't do it much because, like I said, we live in really warm climate out here. So we don't really close the door very often unless it's very, very cold in the winter for a reason. But as you can see, this is the door when it's completely closed. You have your privacy in this bedroom here. And if you want it, if it's too hot, you need to get some air circulating through here. You can open this section, let me show you. So as you can see, you can still have the bottom section of it closed. So if you got nervous about some critters or something coming through or whatever it may be, but you still want circulation, you got this, right? Because I've seen people who use this. Let me get out of here so you can see me a little better. All right, I've seen people who use this tent the way it's kind of set up right now, where for example, they'll just leave this completely open so you can easily access in and out without ever closing this, right? And they only close the bedroom. And then the way to keeping bugs and stuff out of the bedroom is you leave that closed like that, and you don't have to ever worry about closing this section. So it all depends on what you wanna do, your necessities, you know, what is good for you guys and what works out, but this is what we like to do. People have asked me about the lighting. This lighting is actually designed for this tent. So up here, you got a Velcro. And on the back of this LED strip is a Velcro as well. This never is taken off. When I close it, when I open it, it's always there. This is made by Kampa. When I bought it about 2.5, maybe 3 years ago, I think it's point. We bought it and it's designed for this. So you have one, you have two, and you have three. So you have three sections all full of LED lighting. You have a control that will turn it on, dim it, increase it, whatever you want to do to it. And it really makes this thing bright. It's more than enough light that what you need. So if you are getting this tent, I do highly recommend it. Now, the plug it comes with, it's a 12 volt cigarette lighter type plug. So I had to get an adapter, and that's what this is over here. So it comes for a 12 volt. I got this adapter, which turns it from a regular like 120 to a 12 volt adaption. And that's how we are able to plug it up, since normally most people will be using this in the middle of nowhere. They use it with a maybe a solar generator or something like that, and they just plug it up directly to that. We're normally camping where we have full hookup with either water or electricity. So yeah, this is the tent, guys. I mean, I hope you guys have liked it. If you guys have any more questions, anything you want to ask me, feel free to give me something in the comments. Let me know what your questions may be, and I'll be glad to answer any of those things for you. But otherwise, stay tuned. We'll see you in the next one. See you guys.